Now we're going to talk about graph data structure. So this is a graph is a data structure, maybe the most known data structure in computer science. And we are surrounded by graph data structures. Really, I have one graph data structure, actually a big one here. Maybe yours is bigger. But we are surrounded in artificial graphs. Just think of the road network. Another artificial huge graph is Facebook. You have a set of friends. Each friend, each user could be thought as a node. We have a lot of graphs. Our network, our communication means of internet is a graph. Our roads is a graph. Artificial intelligence is mostly based on neural networks. Network is another way of graphs. And obviously, our brain, trees, and fungi are performing, there are different families, they are performing an amazing graphs in their roots, which is a subject to a larger research these days. We want to be motivated by real-world examples, so let's consider the example of the case of road networks. I want to mark my cities as kind of intersections or nodes. So I have a set of cities. In this case, I have five cities. I will mark them A, B, C, D, and E. And between some of those pairs of cities, I have roads. And a road will be defined formally as a node. So I can go from A to B, and from B to C, and from B I can also go to E, and from E I can go to D and C. Now, in some roads, they are symmetric, meaning going north could be as going south. But some roads are one directional. So if my graph is entirely symmetric, we will call it undirected. If there's at least one directed edge, I will define it as a directed graph. In the road network, we will define it as a directed graph, in particular because in many cases, the time it takes from getting from A to B might differ significantly from going on the opposite direction from B to A, maybe because of traffic or bad road conditions or so on. The main motivation for a directed graph in the example of road network will be a one-lane road. So some roads are just connecting from A to B, and there's no road that goes backwards. So in this example, in the simple example, we might consider what is the shortest path, from, say, A to D. Shortest could be either time, distance, maybe the cost, maybe a combined cost of the parameters. But in general, the shortest path could be defined as the sum of the weights of the each path. So if I look at the path, say A, B, E, D, I can sum the set of weights associated with A, B, and then B, E, and then E, D, and compare it to a different path, say A, B, C, D, and then find the shortest path. In that manner, I should mention that the set of algorithms that going over that uses graphs in computer science is a very big research field, and one of the most common algorithm is named Dijkstra, and it uses a graph, a weighted graph, in order to compute the shortest path from a query point A to the entire set of the other nodes. Right, so let's formally define a graph. So a graph is a data structure composed from two sets, V, which is a set of nodes, and E, which is a set of edges. So a V could be thought, in the case of a road network, as an intersection. So the intersection may have the property of position and name, and maybe some extra metadata regarding it. Its most important information is its intersection, where you can go from this node. So an edge will be defined by the two nodes it connects. So commonly we think of an edge to be a pair, to be defined by a pair of nodes, A and B. Each of them belongs to V. And maybe there is a weight associated with this edge. In the case of a road network, you can think of this weight to be either time, distance. In general, we think of it as a weight, but this weight could also represent the price. Maybe it's a road network with a toll regarding assigned to that. So maybe the weight would be just the cost for going through that.